There is this strict code that has been prescribed in the Natya Shastra by Bharata. And this he has done with so much of, I would say, foresight, you know. And everything is prescribed in the text. Everything is there. Every single movement, every single step that one has to learn is everything given in that text. And that has been so carefully handed over from generation to generation to generation, and we have got it. And adhering to that text and trying to, you know, do innovations within the parameters of that text is what I think is tradition. Is what I think is tradition.
But ultimately, is everybody preserving the values of those traditions? If you ask me, I'm afraid I have to say no. Because when it moved from the courts to the stage, as Kalidasa, the great poet Kalidasa said, Loko Bhinna Ruchihi, people of various tastes assembled there. So the dancer had to satisfy all the needs of the audience who are waiting for something to happen on the stage, visually beautiful. So all of them are not educated, some are lay and some are very well versed in the arts. So change in the trend was inevitable.
I see a lot of youngsters, you know, go in for real fast and you know, a lot of leaps and jumps and sweeps, you know, and running around the stage, covering the space, you know. I see a lot of youngsters doing it. But ultimately, you know, I would say that at the end of that performance, the audience feel tired, you know, after watching this, like a storm, you know. They come and go like a storm or like a hurricane, you know.
There are no more serious focus on devotional or spiritual aspects of attaining, you know, something flowering from inside to fulfill your own thoughts and emotions. It's nothing like that. It's purely become entertainment value based, because not all the dancers are really serious and dedicated. So they take it in a lighter stride, you know.
We find artists taking to it for a very short while. I think they are learning to perform.
Just like many organizations crop up and go away, dancers do crop up in like hundreds and 200s and innumerable numbers, but how many sustain to stay there with dignity is a matter of great concern.
They learn for about 3 years or 4 years and want to start. They just want to have their arangetram, and many of them don't turn back to dance after they finish their arangetram. And people who do keep up with the practice, they just want to, you know, keep learning more and more items, which I do not think is very healthy. If they perform one set of items for a program, they don't want to ever repeat it again, which means they will not be able to perform it to the depth that it should be performed.
What is the problem in doing the Mohamana Varnam 100 times all your life? Don't you live in that moment? When you say Enneramam Undan Sannidhiyil, don't you get dragged to Chidambaram mentally? Don't you live that moment? If you cannot, then I think there is some problem in the basic training. These are all part of the current trends. Not only the compositions have differed, not only the values of dancers have changed, the whole scene has become different. and the attitudes of the audience have also changed very much.
Omana tingal kidavo vanna komala tamara po.
How many dancers take it as a serious vocation? Even in the dance class, you can see young dancers when they graduate. I have finished my engineering, I'm going abroad for MS. They don't realize that dance is something like you carry something from your mother. It's like a mother art.
That's it. Up till 12th or for third year, final year, I think they are going to really give up. I'm scared. Because some lovely dancers, when they don't come, I'm getting like very depressed. This child is such a beautiful dancer, she's not coming. She's discontinuing. Dance has become secondary. I can't think, okay, after me some child is going to take up. No assurance. And previously, whatever time our teacher instruct, you must come at 7 o'clock, we are there at 6:30. But nowadays children, they say, Akka, we'll come at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock we have to go. Okay. Another one will come and tell, we'll come at 6, 7 o'clock I have to go. For that, for everything we have to say, nod our heads accordingly to the children. Previously it was not like that. It was very strictly it was ordered. You must come at 7. We are there at 6:30.
In Bala's technique, patience and extraordinary allowance of time are really very important factors. Nobody can be in a hurry. You can't ask for anything. You cannot order for anything. You have to just stay there, watch. Sometimes there may not be a class, but still you may be observing other dancers getting trained by Bala. And that was an education by itself. See, if you take the ballet dancers, you know, their kind of practice and dedication you cannot find in the Bharatanatyam dancers. It's totally different. I have seen some ballet schools, and I think that kind of firm discipline and firm adherence and a very determined effort is very essential right from the young age for Bharatanatyam dancers also. But I think also that the outside influences and the local pressure, all that kind of act very much on the dancers, especially the Bharatanatyam dancers.
But I really don't know whether to blame them or not to blame them. Sometimes I feel very sad because we were all very, very sincere. We just go to one class, only dance or music, and we come back. But nowadays children, they want to learn everything. They go for swimming, they go for keyboard, they go for this, abacus, something and all they say, and they really want to go everywhere. And finally, when they come to dance, they become very tired. So this is what is happening. But anyway, what to do? We have to just get along with the children also. I can't blame anyone.
Dance is part of my life. Bharatanatyam is part of my life. Whatever my teacher, that sampradayam, gave me from Bala and Ganeshan will live with me as long as I live. And I hand it over to my students, my daughter. And that is the real, the essential need of this art.